What's going on? My name is Seth, and I am a filmmaker. I do this professionally for a living. I've done this for quite a few years, the better part of 10 years now, and I wanted to show you guys some of the tips and tricks that I use in order to color my footage from nasty log to this amazing filmic look. So we have a couple of different examples today. I'm gonna grade some Sony footage, some Slog 3, I'm gonna grade some FujiFilm in Flog, and I'm gonna grade some Canon footage in Slog from the EOS R. The FujiFilm is the X-T3 and the Sony was the FX3. So I think this is gonna be a really good way for me to show you guys that you don't have to be amazing at creating your own look. These film emulations that are built into DaVinci Resolve will actually help you to do all of the work. I'm personally a fan of the FujiFilm 3513 film emulation, and the reason why is because some of the coolest movies using this film emulation, a few of those movies being Lord of the Rings. You have Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, The Return of the King, you have Gamer, you have Red was shot on there, the butterfly effect was used. You have The Last Exorcism, Letters to Juliet, The Notebook. Now there's also a ton of movies that have been shot on the 2383 film emulation, Joker being one of them. Joker was one of the best edited movies I've ever even seen. Pirates of the Caribbean, At World's End looked amazing. You have The Dark Knight, Unbreakable, Body Lies, Shutter Island, Cloud Atlas, Thor, Spider-Man 3. Spider-Man 3 was probably the worst out of all of them, but it looked really good. Van Helsing, Superman Returns. Superman Returns wasn't a great movie, but it was film, or like the film emulation, the coloring looked amazing. So these film emulations are used by Hollywood currently, and I'm gonna show you how to use these. This is the same exact process that I used in order to color this video right here with this skater named Alyssa. She is a TikTok skater and she's super cool. If you haven't checked that video out, go ahead and check out the video. There's a title card in the top right of your screen currently. Anyways, we're gonna go ahead and hop right into DaVinci Resolve, and I'm gonna teach you the difference between Kodak 2383 and FujiFilm 3513. All right, so hopping straight into Resolve, we're actually gonna go down to this gear in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. This is gonna be our project settings, and we are going to go to 1080p, and we're gonna do 23976. Now we're here in the color management tab, we're gonna go ahead and go to the color timeline space, and I want to change this to gamma 2.4. So we're gonna go find Rec 709, gamma 2.4. We're gonna do the same thing here. Rec 709, 2.4. The only reason I'm using this color space currently is because we're going to be using footage from Canon, Sony, and FujiFilm. Now, we're gonna go down to this 3D lookup table interpolation, and we're gonna change this from trilinear to tetrahedral. This is gonna allow Resolve to show the LUT a little bit better. So once we've done that, we can pretty much step right out of this whole thing. You can save a preset here if you wanna start with those exact same settings every time. So we're gonna go ahead and click save. Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna come in and we're gonna hop into this footage from the FX3. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna right click on the footage. This was shot in 60 frames per second. We wanna make sure that it has a smooth playback and it's also slow motion. So we're gonna go into clip attributes. We're gonna take this from 60 frames per second. We're gonna drop it down to 23976. This is gonna make DaVinci understand what we're trying to do here. So now we're gonna drop that footage into the timeline, go to the grade tab. I'm gonna go ahead and close the LUT tab. We're not gonna need that just yet. Okay, so the first node on all of my node trees is gonna be noise reduction. If you don't have DaVinci Resolve Premium, this is not really gonna be an option for you at the moment, but it's okay. You could still use the film emulations even without DaVinci Resolve Premium. The next node that we do is always going to be a node that I really like to do called highlights. The following node is going to be exposure. This node is gonna be my white balance. And this node is going to be the CST. So currently we have 6 nodes. We're gonna make this 7. And the 7th one is gonna be the LUT. This is not a normal LUT. So this LUT right here is actually going to put a film print emulation over your footage. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go into this color space transform. We're gonna drop this here onto CST. Now this was shot with the Sony FX3. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna go into Sony S gamut 3, which is the gamut that I used. We're also gonna go down in here into input gamma, and we're gonna go scroll down until we find S log 3. once we've selected that, we already have a fairly usable image. Let's go ahead and play this back a little bit. I mean, Alyssa looks pretty cool. The sky is in exposure. That was all done in camera. But as we can see here with this graph, you know, it's a little bright. So we're gonna actually take this offset and we're gonna darken the whole image just a little bit. That's already a very, very usable image. And so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna actually check out the LUTs. So this is the magic sauce. This is where you're gonna get this cool film look. The specific LUT that I used to color grade this video was actually going to be the FujiFilm 3513. If you like what you're seeing so far, please click the thumbs up button and possibly think about subscribing, because I'm gonna be shooting more of these videos now that I have a little bit more time in my life. So the reason this doesn't look great yet is because we already don't have the correct color space, so we're gonna go ahead and 709, and we also need to change the output gamma to a specific log gamma called Cineon Film Log. So once you do that, it softens everything up. Now, it keeps all of your information in the footage without you ever really clipping your information. I can push it really far and all of your information is still there. The cool thing about that is you can really push this without actually having very many problems. Okay, so now that I'm looking at this footage, I'm realizing that it's a little bit on the cool side. So I'm gonna go ahead and go into my white balance tab, and I am gonna go and warm it up just a little bit on the offset tab. So what the offset tab is gonna do is it's going to change the entire image, right? So if I subtract blue, everything's gonna go toward yellow. If I add blue, everything's gonna go toward blue. And so this is a great starting point in order for you to build your own look after that. So one thing that I really like to do in my images is I like to build a glow and kind of put it into the shadows only, just to kind of brighten up the shadows, and then take the blacks and actually pull them down further in the blacks. And the way that I do that is I pull this shine threshold and spread all the way down, and I change the composite type to soft light. Then I go into the qualifier and just basically pull out just the shadows. So just to show you what that's doing, it's kind of adding a little bit more saturation there, adding a little bit of the blue there. The cool thing is we can actually take this and we can take and add our own color, whatever color we're wanting. So if we're noticing, like, that looks pretty cool. I mean, we really can, I mean, it's basically limitless as to what you can do with this. So now from there, in order to build that film look even further, I actually think we need to move these over and add one more node right here, and we're gonna add this as a Emulation. We're gonna put that on, and we're gonna show our isolated regions. Pull that back. Okay, so now we're gonna scroll in, we're gonna look at Alyssa, and we are going to push that down. Normalization is up, cool. Strength, I'm gonna pull that back. Gamma, we don't need it to be quite as bright because we're looking here at our vector scopes, and we are pulling this quite a bit. So now we can do a secondary glow, kind of push that a little bit. So I think just like that, we made a really, really good looking image. All I really did was I properly exposed the image, properly color space transformed into Cineon Log, and then used the FujiFilm 3513 LUT. I didn't really have to do a ton of difference, just to show you what this looks like. I mean, I can add this LUT, I can change it out to this LUT. They all have a very distinct look to them. I personally really like this. It's the Kodak 2383 D60. It's got a little bit warmer of a look to it, so let's go ahead and look at it. And I can change these LUTs whenever I want. And the way that I've colored this is in a way that it doesn't fall apart. There's no qualifiers pulling skin. There's no teal and orange push. There's nothing crazy that's happening. And this is literally not even a noise reduced image, and you're having this beautiful look. Now in the Emulations tab, I can even go into the basic grain tab and append a grain, pull that strength down a bit, pull the size down quite a bit. And now we have a beautiful grain. It really looks filmic. Okay, now that we've built this amazing look just that fast, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how to save this as a power grade. So we're gonna go to the galleries, we're gonna go to power grades right there, and we're gonna right click this, save as still. Now this still, I'm gonna go ahead and show you how we can apply this to some other footage. So now we're gonna go back into the timeline. We're gonna grab a clip from my FujiFilm X-T3. Okay, so now we selected some FujiFilm X-T3 footage that was shot in F-Log. We're gonna go into this power grade that we had already saved. We're gonna go ahead and right click it and we're gonna apply this grade. Now, you might look at this and say, wow, that looks like dookie. That's because, this is not the right color space for this image. So we're gonna kill that. We're going to reset this grade. We're gonna go reset that grade. This is already looking a lot better just by doing those two things. We need to go back into the CST and we need to change from S-Log to Rec. 709 and we need to change the gamma to FujiFilm F-Log. So now that we've already done that, it's already starting to look quite a bit better. But as we look right here, it is just not looking amazing. So we're gonna go ahead and kind of work with this in the exposure tab. So we're gonna go back over to the exposure node. We're gonna pull those, we're gonna push this. We're gonna pull that. Okay, this is already looking quite a bit better. We're gonna take this white balance and we're gonna really accentuate the warm tones that were in the room. I'm thinking this is looking really, really good. This looks very similar to how it looked in real life. Now let's go ahead and kick back on that halation that we already collected. Boom, I mean, it's just really just making things pop, making them come to life. Let's go ahead and take the saturation and kind of push it a little bit on this halation. And then we're gonna go into this glow and we're gonna pop that back in and that's gonna make everything just come back to life. So this is FujiFilm footage and it doesn't fall apart. It looks great. This is definitely a look. Skin tone is still on the skin tone lines. I mean, that's, again, that's the same exact thing that we did on the Sony footage, but for Fuji. So now I'm gonna show you guys how to do it on Canon footage. Okay, so this footage was provided to me. It was shot in Slog by my friend Zach James. His YouTube channel is Backyard Sport. He's been shooting a lot of stuff and it's been really, really cool. This is the raw footage. It looks great. It's got a nice backlight on it. Backyard Sport, he really knows what he's doing with this footage. It's been looking better and better. And so we're gonna go ahead and start grading this. But the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna look at this and say, that does not look good. So we're gonna go ahead and kill this glow. We're gonna kill the halation. We're gonna reset white balance, reset the exposure. Okay, so now it still doesn't look good. The reason why is because this was not properly converted into the film emulation LUT. This was shot on a EOS R in a Canon Log 3. So we're gonna go ahead and go to the Canon Cinema Gamut. We're gonna go down to Canon C, or we're gonna go up to Canon C Log 3. This is already much more of a pleasing look, immediately, just like that. Next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna throw that halation on. Looks beautiful, and we're gonna pop that glow. The image is being fully expanded. I don't necessarily like my image to be fully expanded. I realized there was an issue there. I actually had converted this into the wrong one. This is Canon Log Gamut, but he's not shot this in Canon Log 3. He's not shooting in C-Log 3, he's shooting in Canon Log. And so now I'm noticing that this image has quite a bit more to work with. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna go to the primaries tab. We're gonna pull this down a little bit. Kind of push the midtones up, kind of pull that back. Okay, so we have a really pleasing image and all we did is slap the halation and slap the glow back on. That's it. I mean, I just showed you three different cameras and how to grade them super fast. And now the best way to save your power grade as something that, that you can use is just build out your node tree. Turn off your halation, turn off your glow, have those preset to your likings. Go back into the CST, kill out what you're doing with your input spaces, and leave your tree just like this. This is all you need right here. This is literally it. So now once we're in the gallery, in the power grade section, so there is stills, timelines, and power grades, we're gonna go ahead and go into power grade. We're going to right click this and we're going to grab still. Now we are going to name this film emulation. Now I can take that and I can put that on any clip anywhere. As long as I know the camera's color space, gamut, and what brand of camera it was, I can honestly grade pretty much anything and give it a very filmic look. Very, very fast. It's honestly kind of like cheating. So this is a great way how to get amazing footage really, really fast. If you made it this far in the video, thank you so much for watching. I know this has been kind of a longer one, but this is really easily how I can grade and give it a very filmic look with no matter what camera it is, as long as I know the color space that it was using and I know the gamut that it was using. If I know those two things, I can easily make their footage look amazing. So you can be a professional colorist without actually being a professional. I hope this video really helped you guys out, and if it did, please consider subscribing and give me a thumbs up if you watched this far and you learned anything. I would love to chat with you in the comments, so you can go ahead and write me in the comments, or you can even email me. I would love to get back to you and talk to you about it. Thanks.